to that.
Everybody, and welcome to On the Fly. I'm Jameson Coyle. Today was one of those days on the couch you dream about. Cheeks firmly planted in place, starting with a 1 p.m. puck drop in Ottawa and wrapping up 9 hours later with the final game of the night out in Seattle. 13-game slate, perfectly staggered. Literally, you could have watched hockey all day and do nothing else. If you didn't, well, you've come to the right place. To the highlights we go.
Last two Stanley Cup winners. Anton Lundell inside his own end with a steal. Wah, down low. Pearson scores! Tanner Pearson all alone in front. His first for the Golden Knights. It's 1-0 Vegas.
Lundell just gives it away, and there's Wah with a touch pass to Pearson.
And the Golden Knights take advantage of a bad turnover by the Panthers.
Up on the wing, it's Lundell. Puts it out in front. Close to Green and couldn't get a stick on it. The season and we're tied.
But good play by Lundell, kind of throwing it to the area. Nice carom off the boards.
And the Panthers have tied it. McNabb got that shot through. Oh, a turnover! Brisson! And Bobrovsky comes over! Another wraparound attempt! Loose at the net! Panthers clear it to the boards.
And you can see Bob just stretched out in that situation there.
That allows Watt to feed Pearson. Pearson looking in front. Adam Boqvist blocked it. Second effort, put towards it and score! Keegan Colasar may have got a piece of that at the top of the crease to tip it home, and Vegas has the lead again.
Lundell for Verhaeghe. Out in front, score! Sam Bennett on the power play from Verhaeghe.
What a play this was. Well-executed play. You can see here Lundell, the drop pass to Verhaeghe, and just the empty net there. What a pass by Verhaeghe.
And we got a big third period coming up. This big crowd at Amarin Bank Arena's loving it.
Howden with a steal, busting in. Backhand score! Brett Howden on the steal! And the Golden Knights have the lead again.
Great hands, great move to the backhand. And Howden's third of the year gives the Golden Knights their third lead of this game.
Ekblad quickly to the net. Glove save, rebound in front, they score! It's at two!
Great play by Aaron Ekblad here, throwing it to the net. What a play in front of the net there.
And battled back again, and we're even. Dennett and Reinhardt with him. Reinhardt walks in, setting it up for the game winner. Let's go home, baby! Get on the Gus Bus! Forsling wins it!
What an overtime that was. You can see the speed coming through the neutral zone here. Goes out wide, Reinhardt. And look where Forsling goes. He doesn't go for a skate behind the net. He plants his skates right in front. Ends up being a tap-in. What a well-executed play by the Florida Panthers, who battled so hard here tonight. Huge 2 points for the boys in red.
Huge wins, big points, you know. I think a lot of guys steps up for the task here, that we're missing a couple guys, and, you know, I think that's good, give us confidence going forward here.
Those two big guys go down, and we're going to Buffalo, and we don't like our game. And then haven't lost in regulation since, so that ability to kind of rally in a tough schedule, I'm really pleased with their work ethic and their I think I like the bench, though, the best. They were wired and from the start, and I like their game.
In the 5 games since Alexander Barkov has been sidelined by a lower body injury, it's been Anton Lundell stepping up in a big way for the Cats. Lundell has 4 goals and 7 points during that stretch, and he's done a great job in the faceoff circle, winning draws at a 60% clip.
Road trip for the New York Rangers continues in Toronto. As two hot teams meet up.
Zibanejad back, and that pass off Riley. Trubel up in front. Stolarz with a big stop off Kreider.
Oh, great pass and deflection by Kreider.
That was Trubel that followed up the play. Actually made the save with his left pad.
Panarin with the puck.
and hit the line. The referee got it up the boards. Long shot. Save on a deflection by Trocheck. Lafreniere scores! Oh, that line does it again. This time it's Alexei Lafreniere. And the Rangers take a 1-0 lead.
He's got so much confidence and so much more patience in his last year plus. He waits and now has a 5-game point-scoring streak to start the season. That line does it again.
Leafs come right back in. Kampf. Ryan Reeves goes to the front. The back pass to Morgan Rielly. Toward the net, it was blocked. Another shot blocked. Another shot saved. And Shesterkin has the puck.
Well, what a save. How about the movement by Shesterkin? He goes to his left, has to stop. Has to go to his right, has to stop. Has to get in position and then makes that glove save.
Outside, Rangers extra skater on. Pass tip, shot, score! Chris Kreider off a beautiful feed from Mika Zibanejad. An extra skater on. Kreider finishes. It's 2-0.
This is just beautiful passing. Rangers keep working. They keep staying on the puck. They keep control of the puck. And eventually, Zibanejad, he knows where his partner is over there on the other side.
Pocket picked by Nyes. Good work. He's got Dobie in. Off the post. Dobie comes close. Tandem in front. That one knocked wide as Robertson had a chance. Leafs doing everything but beating Shesterkin.
Down low, blocked by Miller, big play. Tavares was open. Marner, Tavares, save! Oh, what a good save by Shesterkin.
Putting on a show here in Toronto, isn't he?
Drops it in behind the net. There's Matthews getting away from Fox. In front, scores! Second in as many games for the Rocket Richard Trophy winner. Leafs cut the Ranger lead in half.
He takes DeAndre Miller and takes him out of the play. Shesterkin find Matthews and watch the first two steps so quick and then they'll spin around with the stick.
Ronald Rielly Smith, he plays it back. Empty net for Chris Kreider. He scores! A two-goal game and the Rangers lead it 3-1. Panarin's got an empty net and he scores! Panarin's streak continues. He has scored points in 5 consecutive games and the Rangers put this game away.
Overall, I thought we did a good job. They're going to get their chances, but I thought we limit their momentum swings to you know, obviously big saves by Shesty, but I thought a lot of players in lanes for them to miss the net. Tough road game. It's always tough to come here, so get out of here with 2 points is big.
I mean, I thought we had some good looks, but then there's just a little bit of inconsistency there. So obviously, we'd like that to be better. Needs to be better. Especially when you're going up against you know, teams like tonight who have very good power play, something that they feed off of. So, you know, we need to do a better job of staying out of the box, and then when we get our opportunities, got to execute better.
Alexei Lafreniere off to a hot start in a contract year, building off his strong season in 2023-24. Lafreniere has points in all 5 games to begin the year, which is now tied for the second longest season-opening point streak by a Rangers player aged 23 or younger. Darren Turcotte owns the longest such streak at 11 games.
Tatar off the wall, works it down low where Holla takes a bump from McElrath. Holla gets it back and he scores from a ridiculous angle. It sneaks through Logan Thompson.
Well, that'll get the crowd going. And
McMichael closing in, great look for Wilson. He scores! Tom Wilson on a 4 straight game goal scoring binge.
And that's an amazing shot and he pounds it home. And what a shot that was from Tom. Very similar to all the shots that he has beaten goalies cleanly already. It's just one heck of a shot.
Bastion digging in for the Devils. Chickering fires, rebound there, score! In tight, slam dunk McMichael.
This line has done it again. What a shift by Dubois, McMichael, Wilson, and John Carlson, and Chychrun. They put the heat on the Devils, and it pays off at the end of the line. It's a layup for Connor.
Strome from the bad angle came on through. Delayed penalty call coming up. Bounces in! In front, the Carom winds up in the cage. Ovechkin in the Capitals celebrating a 3-1 lead.
The way Ovi celebrating, I think it might have hit off his skate or body in front. It sort of looped up in the air, and then everybody sort of stopped, and it ends up rolling over the goal line.
You Here's Nason feeding to front. Heischer scores! Bang! 34 seconds in, and the Devils are back within one. It all starts with Stephen Nason going to work behind goal again. And Heischer's right back on the puck. He shoots again!
Place has erupted. Nico Hischier, the captain, 2 goals in 18 seconds.
Send in Mangiapane alone off the head fake. He scores! Andrew Mangiapane.
Great feed up the ice. Caught Mangiapane behind the D with speed. And way to go. He's got his first goal as a Washington Capital.
Kept the point position. And rings like to the front door. Deflection. Score! The hits keep coming for Washington. It's 5-3.
High tip, and it starts from the play of TBR. And there's a deflection by Dylan Strome.
Heischer's already scored twice. He feeds Mercer. Score! Nico Hischier with a beauty of a feed, and Mercer finishes. Nico Heischer's having a night. Devils to the power play. Heischer flips it wide to Hughes, centering. Meyer whacked at it, didn't connect. Hamilton, a one-timer. To overtime.
They activate Jack Hughes. Hughes back door. Sprawling across. Incredible stop. Thompson. Wilson with momentum. 2-on-1. Wilson fires. Score! Wilson wins it. Washington prevails in New Jersey. 6-5.
And Tommy has his 5th goal of the season. 2 goals tonight.
It's a long season. The team's playing really well right now. So the fun thing about right now is everybody's chipping in, and the group's playing really well together. That's all that matters. They're getting me in really good spots to shoot the puck, and we're working off each other. A lot of little things, playing against other teams, top guys, doing a good job getting pucks in. So at times it's going to be hard and it's not going to be pretty, but with those two guys, I like us playing a bunch of different variety of games.
Tom Wilson has exploded out of the gates this year for the Caps, scoring goals in each of the team's 4 games so far, including Saturday's OT winner. That matches the longest goal streak to begin a season in franchise history, most recently done by Alex Ovechkin 10 years ago.
Set it up for Dobson, 22 left on the power play. Barzal handles the puck, Siplikov parked in front. Horvat scores! Barzal finds Horvat in the bumper. Siplikov provides the screen, and the Islanders on the power play have the first goal of the night. Palmieri to the net. Scores! Kyle Palmieri rips it. Stick side on Primo. 2-0 New York.
And what a great outlet pass that was by, I believe that was Dobson, was it not?
Yeah, it was. And when we see it again, watch Dauber's eyes. You get people to bite just a little bit.
Islanders have not taking a lot of penalties this season. That's just the 10th one they've taken as Matheson gets it down to Caulfield. Check that scores! Paul Caulfield puts it in with 2.5 seconds to go under the bar. A power play goal, and the Canadians are on the board. Here comes Jake Evans trying to press his way through. He does. Got it back for Josh Anderson. Tipped it wide. Mayhew scores! Logan Mayhew gets the shot, and it's into the back of the net for his first NHL goal.
Duclair trying to do it himself, taken down, no penalty on that.
He kind of looked like he was stretched out a little bit, didn't he, with his leg? And
you don't want to see someone when they're not moving like that. It's usually pretty bad.
Aerial pass, Pageau bumps it down. Here's J.G. Pageau, shoots save, rebound, score! Anders Lee, Islanders lead it late.
And Page does the smart thing, right? He shoots the puck, Anders Lee drives towards the net.
Suzuki, Boris Lepkovsky. Hands it off, Cole Caulfield's got it, scores! Caulfield's shot sneaks through for his second of the night, and the Canadians tie it at 3.
I'm not sure if this hits something going through, but it really doesn't matter to the Montreal Canadiens, and another goal for Caulfield, who is on a pace, a scary pace.
Golden opportunity for the Islanders, a 4-on-3.
Halfway through overtime, Dobson alone in the slot, off the post! Dobson again! Barzal for Palmieri, wouldn't go! Palmieri up with it again.
Some tired killers for Montreal. Can the Islanders find the one they need? It's into the chest of Caden Primo. We were scheduled for three rounds. We will need at least four. Right-handed shot coming in right side. Slows up and scores!
Kapanen will get a crack at it to try and keep this game alive. Kapanen scores, and he does!
Round nine will start with Noah Dobson. His fourth career shootout attempt. Round nine, scores! He came in with speed. He went glove side. Logan Mailloux, game on the line. And he missed it wide, and the Islanders win! It took 65 minutes and nine rounds of a shootout, but the Islanders win on home ice 4-3 over Montreal.
The Isles and Habs needed nine rounds of their shootout before Noah Dobson got the game winner. Over the past 10 years, New York has only played in one shootout that went longer than Saturday's game. It was a 14-round beauty against the Ducks back in 2016.
This one should be fun. Stars and Oilers, and part of a very good start to this star season where they're 4-1, perfect in this building, and yet still there's one area, Razor, where they're really looking for improvement.
Yeah, it was an area of culpability in the loss to the Oilers in the Western Conference Final, and it's off to a slow start this year, the power play.
And now we've got a hooking call coming.
Right there, coming through the neutral zone, just a little tug on McDavid by Ben.
This is an Oiler power play that was dominant, has been dominant, but they have had their struggles to start the season just like the Stars have.
Nugent Hopkins will corral, center, and that was stopped. Hyman had it blocked, cleared by Blackwell, and that will be all for the opening 20 minutes. 46 seconds of power play carryover time.
McDavid to Bouchard, pass was in his skates. Shot was saved by Under, rebound, and Dreisaitl blasted it wide and couldn't believe it.
Two shots on the power play for the Oilers, but they're now 1-for-14 this year. Oh, here's a battle one by Hicks, and he can't tuck it home. I don't know how that stayed out. A combination of Skinner and Arvidsson, perhaps, but we do have a penalty coming. The trip on Hicks.
Yeah.
Power play for the Oilers. And now breaking out is Beck as the power play expires. Dallas enters the zone. Neither team able to break through.
Over to the left, Robertson curls behind the net, tripped up. That's going to be the first penalty of the game against Edmonton. 1-for-17 on the season. And this was the area that proved to be the difference in the playoff series. Here's Duchesne. He scores! 2 seconds is all they need on the power play to cash in and take the lead. 1-0 Dallas leads despite the lopsided shots on goal favoring Edmonton. Bouchard lost his footing. Gets back upright. Marchment, though, gloves it to himself. He's in. Pass. Score! Duchesne! Set up by Marchment. Matt Duchesne has both. And the Stars double their lead. But still a club that got off to an 0-3 start. Consecutive wins. Trying to crawl back to 500 on the young season. Now facing a multi-goal deficit. And the Stars in front. Hintz makes it 3. And late in Dallas, the Stars breaking it open.
A lot of sublime Jake Oettinger in the early going. Stars got through two early power plays for the Oilers. That was key in this contest today.
Now or never time for Edmonton. They pull the netminder, have 6 out there.
Here's McDavid, centering pass open. Nugent Hopkins over to Dreisaitl, and he scores. And Edmonton may not be done just yet. It's 3-1. Oettinger denied a chance for his 12th career shutout.
Jason Robertson. Stick handles in, an empty net bullseye from close range, restores the 3-goal lead.
Stars are now 5-1, Edmonton drops to 2-4.
Yeah, they were great. You know, those guys have been, they've been good right from day one. So consistently creating offense for us. You know, Mush has been outstanding, I think, so has Dutchie. You know, I feel like wherever we kind of stick with them, they help them. So they've been a critical piece for us, like they were last year at the beginning of the season. Listen, we're through 6 games. Our game isn't perfect. Our penalty kill and our goaltending have been outstanding, which has given us a chance to win every game we've been in.
The Stars are off to a great start this season, and goaltender Jake Oettinger is a big reason why. Oettinger stopped 30 of 31 shots Saturday, improving to 4-0-0 on the year with a save percentage of .953. Only two Dallas goalies have owned a better start to a season, Kari Lehtinen and Marty Turco. Coming up, it was a family affair in St. Louis when the Joseph brothers teamed up on Matthews' second period goal. That put the Blues on the board, but there was plenty more firepower to come.
This overtime game winner is powered by the long-lasting power of Energizer. Still going.
Full of everyday heroes is just how he likes it. The industrial-grade products you need. Call, click, or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Season now, Carolina in front, the score, taking advantage, Aho to Mr. Svechnikov, and that's the magic in St. Louis, 1-0 Carolina.
That's borderline a joke of a pass by Sebastian Aho because it was that good. Look at the route of Aho. He had backtracked to be a responsible high forward and centerman, but once he recognizes two wingers that turn the puck over, he jumps. The uncanny sixth sense to go to Svechnikov for a tap-in. Well, that's a beauty in the first minute and change here in St. Louis.
At the line, Theo Joseph to Shen. Matthew Joseph turns. He scores! Matthew Joseph has tied the game at one. What a shot!
Just a great goal there by the Blues as they hound the puck to get in on it. Matthew Joseph scores, putting it up top shelf. Gotta love that.
Here's Neighbors turning with the puck. Neighbors shoots, and he scores! Neighbors! And the Blues, two quick one, and they have taken a 2-1 lead.
Neighbors zips that puck. Look at Buchnevich and the Canes defense from the goalie side. Nothing on that play at all.
Drop pass to Broberg. He's got really good speed. Here he comes in front. Holloway a shot. He scores! Holloway! His first goal as a St. Louis Blue. And the Blues have taken a 3-1 lead. How about that?
What an incredible goal there by the Blues, Dylan Holloway. Amazing effort overall. Quick puck movement, short passes. Tell me those guys aren't loving it here in St. Louis right now. Just a beautiful goal.
This is the power play. They're down 3-1. A couple of power play goals last night, but you really need one.
Back for Aho, Gostisbehere. Does he have a lane? He takes it, he scores! And there's your power play goal, Trip. Carolina has cut the lead to one, and that is three in a row for Shane Gostisbehere. Now Robinson shoots, he scores! Oh, making Roslovic across the way. And Jack Roslovic with the tweak, it pays off. And Roslovic has got a goal in two straight games. And just like that, Carolina's tied it at three.
Pass to Neighbors, now for Kapanen. He busts in, shoots, he scores! Kapanen, what a goal! And the Blues are back on top at 4-3.
Kasperi Kapanen using his speed and great finish on that play there. Leans in here and then pulls it up and tucks it up over the glove. Great, great skills right there.
And that'll do it. And the Blues hang on and win 4-3.
Well, Philip Broberg is making Blues general manager Doug Armstrong look like a genius so far. Broberg, who signed an offer sheet with St. Louis in August, has points in all six games so far this season. That matches Steve Duchesne for the longest season-opening point streak by a Blues defenseman in franchise history.
For the sixth time, the Canucks are here to start the Flyers' home season, third time in the last 4 years.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Here's a shot. Sherwood off the back wall. Savers and wrap around the other way. Erson trying to get over there. And did it stay out? Apparently it did.
One shot, then the follow-up by Sherwood. And you can see he's got his skate right up against it. He's just trying to push up against that post, make sure that it doesn't loosen up.
Lawton was taken down in front of the Vancouver bench. Fans react to that. Garland working in the corner. Back to Hronek. Fans not happy with the officials. Here's a centering pass, Pettersson to the side, Hoglander scores! That won't make the fans any happier. Pettersson to Hoglander with a wide open net.
And the Canucks have a 1-0 lead in Philly.
Pettersson comes out front to the top of the slot. Nobody's got Hoglander off to the glove side. And this swarm defense by Philly gets caught up with a tap in for Nils Hoglander.
Now to the near side. Here's Frost across to the crease and missing a tip-in try was the veteran. Eric Johnson just couldn't reach that pass with a wide open net. Gets the puck down into rush. Centers Myers. Stop. Besser with the rebound. Scores. Tyler Myers won't celebrate his 1,000th game with a goal just yet. And mom and dad, congratulations to Tyler. He's got a point in his 1,000th game.
DeBrusk sticks with it. And after he gets it back, near side pass out front. Myers, after getting stopped, realizes he can backhand it to an oncoming Brock Besser. And Besser on the backhand, the Canucks 2-0. Smile there from Myers on the bench. Whoa!
Another goal right off the draw. Kiefer Sherwood whipped it home past Ersson. And a face-off win and a shot to the net by Kiefer Sherwood has made it 3-0 Vancouver.
From Bluger's stick to Sherwood's toe tape and past him, stunned Ersson.
Scott Lautner digs the puck for it. Puts it to Konechny. Here's Frost in front! And sliding to his right was Lankinen to make the save. Nice three-way passing play down low by the Flyers there. Now a chance for the Flyers shorthanded, and the puck went off the end of Sanheim's stick as he tried to tuck it home. Flyers looking to force a turnover. Puck loose at the side. Sanheim in front, and Couturier this time. Another golden opportunity. Tyler Myers, the eighth Canuck to play his 1,000th game in a Vancouver uniform, but he's only the second to pick up a point in his 1,000th game in a uniform. Marcus Naslund was the other to do it, and Kevin Lankinen gets the shutout. Fourth of his career, Canucks win 3-0.
25 years since the Flyers were shut out in their home opener. For the fourth time in team history, Canucks, Kevin Lankinen, do the trick here tonight.
With Thatcher Demko unavailable to start the season, Kevin Lankinen is doing his best to keep Canucks fans calm, at least for now. Lankinen 2-0-1 with a .953 save percentage in his first three starts for Vancouver, which includes his shutout of the Flyers on Saturday. Coming up, the Flames took the ice for warm-ups knowing they were the last unbeaten team in the National. The Kraken looking to end Calgary's franchise record-setting start to the season.
It's game night on NHL Network.
Gorgeous! The Avalanche.
The Kings.
Flames.
Take on the Canadiens.
Follow all the action.
The Senators.
Flyers.
The Hurricanes.
Take on the Blackhawks.
Take on
the Maple Leafs.
All season, NHL Network has live games featuring the league's best.
So I'm going to circle every single game.
Don't miss game night on NHL Network.
Are you kidding me?
Let's drop the puck.
Let's drop the puck.
Let's drop the puck.
Live hockey lives on NHL Network.
Schedule free mobile service now at safelight.com.
Safelight repair, Safelight replace.
Let's go!
Imagine if the most exciting, unthinkable, iconic NHL moments could be yours. Well, now they can, because NHL Breakaway lets you collect highlights from your favorite players and teams. Collect a moment, relive a memory, and trade history with these officially licensed digital collectibles. Make history yours with NHL Breakaway.
And somehow, the Kraken don't open the score. Dug out, Klapka in front. Decord says no on Michael Backlund. Great stop by Joey Decord.
The puck just gets centered right out in front. Backhand opportunity goes wide.
That's here, two on one the other way. His shot stopped by Lennard. Rebound underneath Dan Lennard, who kept track of the puck against Brandon Montour.
Lennard. Not once, but twice he finds his chance, and he's able to keep it out.
And a pretty good chance there by Montour.
And the Kraken headed to the box.
And the Flames go on the first power play for them of the game. Their power play has been much better since really the second half of last season.
Now Backlund, empty net for Anderson. Couldn't one time it in, but the cord caught out. Coleman, slap shot, scores! Blake Coleman with 7.4 left, opens it up.
for Calgary.
The scramble is on. He gets somewhat back to the net. Anderson's doing a good job creating the traffic. The court never picks it up. And the shot from well out beats him.
Well, these situations are always consequential, one way or the other. 5-on-3. They say if you score, you might have good fortune. If you don't, you might not, in terms of the game. Anderson under duress. Schwartz. Chandler Stephenson. McCann Stephenson. Scores! Chandler Stephenson! He lets it rip on the power play. His first goal as a Seattle Kraken has tied it.
How about the job by Jaden Schwartz? The first shot hit him. This one here, look at the screen. He jumps up. Vladar never sees it. The Kraken have tied it up.
Tolvin off the draw win for the Kraken. Shot blocked by Zeri. Bounces. Gaping cage for Tolvin, who tried to untime it on the choke up out of the air.
Wristing one. Blocker saved to Cord. Coronado. Shot blocked in front. Kadri wouldn't go. And it's covered by DeCord.
Joey with a couple of big saves in that sequence.
We are headed to overtime in Seattle.
Nazem Kadri, a steal, Montour, stopped by Vladar, Montour gets it, Eberle scores! Hey, hey, what do you say? Jordan Eberle and the Kraken win in overtime!
But the captain leading by example and scores a huge OTGWG.
The Kraken ran their winning streak to 3 games with the overtime victory over Calgary. Seattle has outscored opponents 15-8 during the winning streak and also dealt the Flames their first loss of any kind this season.
Another shift in the offensive zone for the fourth line.
Take it away. Kraus has got it. Kraus looks to take a shot. Oh, and he tried to tuck it in behind Swayman. And Swayman will cover up. Right idea, Lawson Kraus.
Send it up the middle. Scrambling into Stone. To the middle, his shot blocked up high. The Bruins rush it out to center ice. Here's Marchand. Now for Koepke, right circle. Shoots, he scores! Cole Koepke staying hot. He opens it up. Bruins 1, Utah nothing.
Is the shot blocked? Now the puck's up for grabs. Marchand, as he's done his entire career, just wins so many battles. Keeps the play alive. This is late in the shift for Brad Marchand. And he just keeps the play alive, pushes the puck ahead, and he just snaps it 5-1.
Short-handed he goes. Kessering shoots, he scores! No! Everybody thought that was in. I thought it was in as well.
Looks like it hit the far post and came out.
Instead, it's Utah. Sergachev feeds. Gunther shoots deflected. Swayman dives back with the left arm. He kept it out of there.
Hayton's there trying to jam home a rebound, but Swayman, athletic enough, strong enough, got some help from people in front of him, able to get that necessary draw.
And Michelli will bring it along for Kyler Yamamoto. Picked up by Michelli.
Across, shot, and a stop, and a rebound, they score!
All right, so Boston is challenged. If they win the challenge, the goal comes off the board.
And it appears, otherwise the Bruins would challenge, that both his skates are clearly inside the white paint and that puck isn't fully in yet.
The play was deemed to be offside. There's no goal.
And the fans, the great fans here in Salt Lake City behind their team. Kolyachonov, Kazan, he scores! Oh, my! What a shot! What a move!
He catches all the Bruins sleeping. No one expects the defenseman to get up in the rush. And how about the power move to the backhand over and up from a defenseman, Nick? Wow.
The Utah Hockey Club 2-1 in overtimes this season. Boston 1-0. Out high. Penalty about to expire. Michelli has it. Logan Cooley with it. Cooley looking around across. Kesselring.
He scores! Michael Kesselring!
Cooley uses his feet. All eyes from Boston move to Cooley, and when that happens, that opens things up. And we saw Kesselring, Nick, ring one off the post earlier in this game. And this time, he finds the twine.
The Coyotes franchise moving to Utah appears to be a big boost against the Bruins. Boston was 19-1-1 in their final 21 games against the Coyotes prior to the move, but already lost their first ever matchup against Utah.
No score on the board.
Now it's on the right side. Paterka dropped it off, and they hit the post. Back close to being 1-0 Buffalo.
And you can see it finds its way through right off the bar. Now it comes back the same way. So the goaltender is looking over his right shoulder, but it's coming back to his left side right now. But there are no Sabres around for that rebound.
Alex Tuck tapping that one back. Paterka gains the line, drops for Thompson, scores! Tage Thompson, that was about as clean a goal as you're going to get as he rips it right through Soderblom, and the Sabres have a 1-0 lead.
But he can shoot the puck, and you saw it right there.
He's got a lethal wrist shot.
Left wing to center and into the Hawks zone. Lafferty going to the net, he was wide open. There's a shot that takes a deflection, they score! Right in front of the net, Malenstein looks like he's the one celebrating the last touch on that one. The Sabres have a 2-0 lead.
Being at the right place at the right time can pay huge dividends.
Sabres looking for their first power play goal of the season. They're 0-17. As the Hawks have a chance short, and Foligno right in! Pad save by Luukkonen. Nice move by Foligno, another right pad stop by the Sabres goaltender. So the number 5 ranked power play in the NHL goes to work for the first time tonight. There's a one-timer, that's why rebound Bertuzzi can't pull the trigger. Came off the end boards, he had a lot of room.
Puck comes out,
oh,
he whipped on
it. Oh my goodness. Carried in by Apodiciu. We'll bring it out the far side. Turned, it was forehand, sliding across for the one-timer. Luukkonen got over to get a piece of that one.
Yeah, he got all of that one.
Now Reichel at center. Nice pass over to Craig Smith for the shot. Scores! His first is a Hawk, and it's a one-goal game.
Just a great pass. Reichel's pass was right on the tape. The hard-shooting right-hander Smith. A lot of whipping that stick right now, and he absolutely handcuffs the goaltender.
14 points, 14 career playoff games for Bertuzzi as well. Here stands Reichel right in. Stop, Ruben. They score! It's Craig Smith again! Two for him. This one's tied. 2-2 in the second. 25th multi-goal game of his career.
This game is all tied up at 2 apiece.
Tage Thompson, deep in the hot zone, brings it top of the right wing circle. Turns, sends it across. Paterka scores! Great puck movement by the Sabres, finding J.J. Paterka, who does it again.
You got the lead going into the third. Now you got to learn to close this out.
Bertuzzi's pass. Kurashev takes a big hit. Stepping up on him is Peyton Krebs. Bertuzzi didn't like that. And you see the result of that hit at center ice.
Everybody's in. You just love the camaraderie shown and the fact that Bertuzzi saw something happen and jumps in for his line mate, and then everybody jumps in after that.
Extra attacker out for the Hawks, down by a goal. Here's Bertuzzi. Oh, the shot. Never got through. Loose puck. Bertuzzi gets it over. Bumped on that. Luukkonen able to make the save on a bouncing shot. And he hangs on.
Sabres with a chance of a 2-on-1 now with an empty net. Chance to bury it, and there it is from McLeod. Sabres' fourth goal of the night comes with 25.6 seconds left in the game, and they take the wind out of Chicago.
Coming up next, we'll go north of the border where Nikita Kucherov netted his league-leading 7th goal, but the Sens special teams would put the Lightning's perfect start to the test. That's next on The Fly.
Hey. Terrific!
Nikita Kucherov is absolutely world-class. Kuch is an artist out there.
When you're hot, the puck just finds you.
Austin Matthews.
To be able to score 60 goals doesn't happen very often. Watch out for 34.
So here we are in Ottawa, first of four meetings this season. The Ottawa Senators won 3 of 4 last season.
And the Lightning certainly would like to change that here this afternoon.
Still no shot here. Here's the one-timer, and it's a goal for Drake Batherson. A power play marker has the Senators on the board early.
But what you need to get is movement to try and open up seams, and that seam opens up as Chernak can't get out in time to front the shot from Batherson. Giroux puts it on his tape.
Here's Batherson. Giroux driving to the net, a pass it for a goal! It's Josh Norris! And here is the start that the Senators were looking for tonight.
Ben Vasilevsky has trouble recovering to get to the short side as Norris beats him for the 2-0 lead.
Gensel drops it back to the line. Chernak with a shot. He cuts down Pinto right in front of his own net. Across to Kucherov. Scores! Nikita
Kucherov stays hot. That is a four-game goal scoring streak.
Well, he's just a machine. I mean, you can't sleep on this guy. He'll do it any time, any place on the ice. And Kucherov lets go of the one-timer, and Kucherov has his seventh of the season.
Here's a chance in front for Cirelli. Rebound! They score! Nick Paul follows up and ties this game. The former Senator makes it 2-2.
This line's played well in this game, probably better than most. Really good work by Cirelli, who's always got the motor going.
Here's Cirelli getting the pass back. Forsberg a save. Not one, but two. And Forsberg, does he still have it? Puck loose. Somehow it stays out. And Stutzla diving to get the puck out of the Senator's zone. Puck stolen. Backerson's in. He scores! Second of the night, the Senators regain the lead. It's 3-2. He tucks it in off of that far post with not a lot of space to work with.
Zach MacEwen closed off by Hedman. Good work by this line. Quick shot scores! Jake Guentzel has his first goal as a member of the Lightning, and he has tied this game 3-3.
Here's Drake Batherson back to Stutzla. Leads one timer. Vasilevskiy ready. Kachuk scores! The Ottawa captain is on the board, and the Senators with another one-goal lead. It's another power play goal. Here comes Shane Pinto. A pass across. Gregor scores!
Gregor, with that great speed, waits for Pinto to cross the line. When he does so, he takes off. He is not to be caught.
Here's a chance now for the Lightning. Nice play by Shabazz. Center! They score! Chafee gets one right back for the Bolts to get them back within one.
Yeah, it goes off Stutzla's stick. Stutzla's there on the backtrack, and you can see him slowly making his way to the Ottawa bench.
Well, that's going to do it. Ottawa back into the win column, and they deliver the Lightning their first loss of the season.
The Senators' power play is absolutely on fire lately, clicking at 50% over the past three games. Ottawa has seven power play goals in that three-game stretch, and defenseman Jake Sanderson leads all Sens in power play points during that span with five.
It's about time to honor Luke Shen for game number 1,000.
Though an ultimate testament to who you are as a player and a person is what your teammates say about you, and everybody that played has played with that man says exactly the same thing. Been one of the best teammates they've ever had. We're carrying on where they left off. A couple good chances early in the first.
Shen scores! Oh, what a story! The ceremony just minutes ago, and Luke Shen dials it up from the point and gives the Predators the lead. Oh, the Shen family is rocking in the suite.
You couldn't draw it up any better. What a goal by Luke Shen.
Jonathan Berggren bumped off the puck. Kasper over to get it. Berggren in front. Tarasenko scores! Tarasenko, Berggren, and Kasper could have a point here as it's a 1-1 tie.
And then Kasper back to Berggren. Bingo! Right on the stick of number 11, Tarasenko. And we got a 1-1 game.
Dalgeisel coughed it up, played back. Rasmussen looked in front. Penalty coming here to Nashville.
Number 7, Nashville. 2 minutes for hooking.
Gustafson for Kane. They took the lane away to shoot past Ello. What a save! Rebound! Scores! Larkin! The break it denied, but Larkin buried it. Power play goal, and it's 2-1.
Well, as I said, they really needed this power play to cash in.
And Nashville will have a two-man advantage. Nashville, for the first time, is on the power play, and it's a 5-on-3. Nashville still with their first power play attempt of the afternoon.
It's frustrating when you're in the moment like they are right now.
Forsberg dials it up. Rebound, Josi. And
post.
It hit the post! That was Marchessault! A barrage! Stamkos scores! Steven Stamkos! His first goal in the gold jersey of the Predators! It's a 2-2 tie!
And you knew it was just a matter of time. 555 goals with the Tampa Bay Lightning. His 556th.
Knocked down by Kopp for Fisher. Loose puck off his skate. Gathered back in, Valeno, they score! Kopp in front, off the feed by Joe Valeno, and it's 3-2!
And there's not much a goaltender can do in a play like this. It looks awful, but it's like, wow, really?
Nashville empty net. Couldn't find it cleanly. Simon Edmondson lifts a high one for the empty net. Edmondson, he scores! Simon Edmondson, an empty net goal! Ahead for Andrew Kopp with the empty net. He scores!
That sums it up, and you can really sense the frustration right now in the arena.
And the Red Wings are going to sweep the Predators twice, beating them in October.
Whether it's posts or lucky saves or whatnot, things have been going in the net, so it was nice to see one go in. Obviously in a big time in the game to tie it up, but you know, you always want to contribute. Feels a little better when it's in a win. Listen, we're all human. At the end of the day, you feel those emotions, but it's tough to win in this league if you're not competing for the full 60. And I know it's cliche to say, but we've seen it. We know what it can be, and now we got to go out there and execute it for as long as we can.
Another game, another loss for the Predators, who have started the season now 0-5. Nashville, who entered the year with big expectations after a banner offseason, has been outscored 23-10 during the losing streak. The Preds only have one longer winless streak to begin a season, seven games back in 2002-2003. Coming up, the Wild have not trailed in regulation this season, and they had no plans to start on Saturday. Would the Gus Bus hold on to an early one-goal lead? Find out next.
It's time to stir up the conversation. See how we rank the best of the week.
Loads it up, scores!
And see if you agree. Tune in every week for the results of Top Shelf. Saturday, 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
That should hold it for now.
Minnesota, a 2-0-2 start to the season. They're the only team in the NHL that has not yet played a single second while trailing.
The Blue Jackets are playing winning hockey.
It's a brand of hockey that the players love playing this way. It's in your face. It's relentless.
Penalty coming against the Blue Jackets as Eriksson Ek was tripped along the wall. And Minnesota will get the game's first chance on the power play. Sends it around the boards for Ogren. Into the corner, Johansson. Tried to leave it for Gaudreau, but it's intercepted and cleared all the way down. Trannan, in the middle, Rossi, he scores! Marco Rossi with his second of the year. Here he has the game's first goal. Minnesota's in front for the fifth consecutive game.
Well, this is a forechecking goal. Nice feed to Rossi, and he's able to finish that one off. Tarasov deep in his net. Rossi with plenty of time to pick his head up.
Merrill up the middle on the stretch pass. Loudko breakaway in on goal! Another huge save from Daniil Tarasov.
Tarasov gets moving laterally and Lauko goes to the backhand but tries to tuck it in behind the pad versus chipping it up over the pad.
Ustadinov back to Middleton, winds and fires. Tarasov with a save, rebound, they score! And Tarasov flopping around is beaten on the rebound.
It looks like it gives the Wild a 2-0 lead, but it's definitely Harris bumped into Tarasov, pushed in by Lauko.
After coach's challenge video review, it was determined that there was goaltender interference.
A successful coach's challenge by Columbus.
We have our third penalty.
The goal comes back. They thought they were up 2-0. Now the Blue Jackets get an opportunity due to a 4-minute high sticking call.
Huge moment in the hockey game.
Marchenko into the circle for Monahan, but he missed the target. And the Wild kill off 4 minutes of a Columbus power play and maintain a 1-0 lead. And he throws it out of play. And we're going to get a delay of game call against Columbus. Minnesota will get a power play. Back for Boldy. He's tripped. And the Wild will get 94 seconds of a two-man advantage. Moves through the middle. A one-timer, they score! Kaprizov, 5 seconds into the two-man advantage, and Minnesota extends the lead to 2.
Faber takes good ice, and Kaprizov just presents his stick. He unloads on one. Tarasov can't catch up to this one.
Hands to Kaprizov. Back for Zuccarello. To the backhand. He scores! Zuccarello off the feed from Kaprizov, and Minnesota stretches it out to 3-0.
Beautiful rush play here. It's Kaprizov again. He attacks the middle of the ice. A drop and cross, a little backhand feed to Zuccarello. Zuccarello, quick little chip shot backhand. Here comes Tinikov, cutting, shooting. He scores! Yegor Tinikov! 1:25 to go, third period. And finally, the Jackets are on the board.
Looks like he runs out of room, but he pauses and cuts just enough. He gets away from that stick of Brodin.
Minnesota will earn the victory here in Columbus tonight. They'll improve to 3-0-2.
Time now for your three stars of the night. Your third star of the night is Rangers goalie Igor Shesterkin, who stopped 34 of 35 Toronto shots in a 4-1 victory. Shesterkin has allowed one goal in each of his last two starts. Your second star of the night is Tom Wilson, who scored twice, including the OT winner against the Devils. Wilson now has goals in all four of Washington's games this season. And your first star of the night is Vancouver goalie Kevin Lankinen, who blanked the Flyers in a 3-0 victory. Lankinen has a .953 save percentage in three starts for the Canucks this season. Canucks got the win against the Flyers Saturday, but that wasn't the only good news for Vancouver. Dakota Joshua, who's recovering from surgery over the summer that successfully removed testicular cancer, participated in morning skate with his teammates. Joshua still on injured reserve, but is traveling with the team on their four-game road trip, and Coach Rick Tocchet called it a good step in his recovery. All right, that's all the time we have for On the Fly. I'm Jameson Coyle. Thanks for watching. We leave you now with the very best from Saturday. Enjoy.
Great matchups all over the ice tonight.
We got ourselves a Saturday afternoon party.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Everybody's in. Two goals in 18 seconds for the Devils' captain.
The first one was definitely the hardest.
Sergei Bobrovsky.